describe Matt as one of the most rational men I've ever met. He's brilliant, incisive.
Well, Matt Meselson is known by every student who grows up studying molecular biology. He was one of the founding fathers of the field of molecular biology.
I met Matt Meselson when I went to Caltech in the fall of 1953, just after Francis Crick and I had found the double helix.
The following summer, which was the summer of 1954, I came to Woods Hole, Massachusetts to be Jim's teaching fellow in the physiology course. And at the same time, Francis Crick was there, Sidney Brenner came through, Rosalind Franklin was there.
It was a very exciting time in biology.
It's as though you took 1,000 years of history and just woo, because of all these really brilliant people doing these amazing experiments.
And he did one of the most important experiments that confirmed the model of how DNA is copied. That is, that the two strands of the double helix unwind and each strand becomes a template for the other. Meselson and Frank Stahl provided the experimental evidence for that model in 1958.
Part of the thing about this experiment, though, was how beautiful it was. You know, people say it's the most beautiful experiment ever done in biology.
It had an enormous impact because it fundamentally taught us how DNA replicates. It underlies human genetic diseases. It underlies all the genetics that we think about. So it was a profoundly important observation.
And then I applied the same method, density gradient centrifugation, together with Sidney Brenner and Francois Jacob, who had come to Caltech to use the isotopes and the method that I was able to do to find out if messenger RNA exists, and we found that it does.
Messenger RNA is essentially a transient information carrier from DNA, which is the inherited information carrier, to proteins, which are the building blocks of our cells.
We wouldn't understand the basic way that genes are expressed if we didn't know about mRNA.
Then I got interested in a quite different thing. Beginning in 1963, I spent the entire summer living in Washington and working in the United States Arms Control and Disarmament Agency. And my assignment was to work on chemical and biological weapons.
Matt was an advisor at the highest level to the president, and many consider his work there to be instrumental in the United States ultimately signing the Geneva Convention that prohibits chemical and biological weapons being used in warfare.
I think what you find with Matt is that he strictly dealt with scientific matters and the extent to which he could use reason and science to tamp down the bad stuff as opposed to pushing it up.
Matt Meselson has done basic research for his entire career, and this is really why he's lauded as one of the top scientists in the world. Basic research, which is what most of the science that we do at Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory, is the science of discovery.
You know, all our world today would be impossible without basic research.
Well, genetics and biology have really only just begun, really, in terms of being able to use this knowledge to do things that are beneficial to people and to society. So I can't predict what will happen, except it's obvious that there will be an enormous number, not only of understandings, but of applications.